watches Greg Laurie quotes false teachers to distort the Bible's teaching on hell. Laurie claims people in hell send themselves there and that they want to go to hell. This is not true. The biblical teaching is found in 2 Corinthians 4, which says, "But even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing, whose minds the God of this age has blinded, who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them." And then in 2 Thessalonians 2, verses 9 through 11, the Apostle Paul says the coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan, with all power, signs, and lying wonders, and with all unrighteous deception among those who perish, because they did not receive the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this reason God will send them a strong delusion, that they should believe the lie. Nobody wants to suffer in hell, such a concept is absurd. And nobody can send themselves there. God is the judge, he decides, not us. But this is yet another flaw in Laurie's theology, that God is ultimately not in control, rather mankind is in charge. This is what happens when a Bible teacher denies the doctrine of God's sovereignty.
People will be in heaven and in hell because of a deliberate choice, the result of a choice they make. C.S. Lewis said, quote, "No one goes to heaven deservingly, and no one goes to hell unwillingly," end quote. Timothy Keller made this statement about hell, quote, "People only get in the afterlife what they most wanted." Well, what about that? How could a God of love send someone to hell? Well, the simple answer is God doesn't send anyone to hell. We effectively send ourselves there.